Here it is, guys. My Alfa Romeo 155. It needs a bath, right? So guys, Alfa Romeo 155. This car here, I bought it 10 years ago with the purpose to repair it and sell it. As you can see, I did not sell it. I don't want to sell this car, and at least anymore, because I am very attached to it. When I first began to repair the car, first of all, the car was very bad. The timing belt had snapped off, the gearbox was leaking and very bad. I also repaired the suspension elements, the brakes, brake fluid, everything that you can imagine mechanically I repaired. I also did some things with the interior. I will show you later. So the main purpose of this buy was to repair it and sell it. But along the way, as I was repairing the car, I can feel myself being more and more related to the car, and that feeling told me, okay, maybe this is more than just liking the car, liking the brand. Maybe this is the beginning of something more. And as you know, today I have this car and I have three more cars. I don't plan to sell this car. This is actually my main car, daily use car. My wife uses my 156, and the other two cars are weekend cars. So, how is it to drive? For you that have this car, you know, but as you may know, every Alfa Romeo is a little bit different. This one, for example, is a turbo diesel 1.9. As you can see, it pulls really well. It's very pleasant to drive. The power steering works very well. I had a repadded steering wheel. It was very bad up in here. The gears work very well as well. Very good. The brake pedal feels very firm and strong. The car brakes very well. I have good brakes. Front and rear, these brakes, front and rear, from factory. The turbo diesels were using these brakes at the rear. For your information, if you want to know, I have Hella Pagid brake discs and pads. I like that very much, but they don't work on this car. They squeal a lot. On the contrary, on my 156, I use only ATE, or AT, as you want to call it. It's a very comfortable car, despite it being lowered a little bit, only with springs. I don't believe very much in car lowers, because I don't want to race my cars. I just want to drive it comfortably, and I want to look good on the road when the car is stopped. The shaking is just because of the support of the camera. The support is very broken. Okay, here comes a bump. Support is really broken. It's held on with tape. More things, this car has air conditioning, working ABS, semi-working window regulators. That one works well. This one does not work. It works, but the switch here is not working. I will do videos about these switches. I repaired a lot of them, but for some reason, for me, the switches are always bad. I already bought new switches, but they were worse than the used ones. If you can imagine that. I also installed, you cannot see from there, boost gauge, so I can control my boost, obviously. It came handy once a pipe burst, and I knew I had a problem with the boost. I knew right away. I eventually would find out, but in that way I knew in the first second. I also have here a DVD unit, a head unit, Tudin. It was very difficult to install because I have the heater for the passenger, rear passengers, passing through this cavity, but it's there. Now it's completely outdated because of the Android radios and so on, but this head unit has 5-6 years and is already outdated. Amazing. I only blast metal in here, only metal. So guys, here it is, the inside of Alfa Romeo 155, on my Alfa Romeo 155. As you can see, here is a turbo diesel engine. I'm very sorry about the wind. It is not easy today to do this video. I have here the correct antifreeze for the car, the new thermostat that I talked about in the last video. I have good functioning ABS with the oil already replaced. I have the air conditioning working well. The fuel filter is replaced and purge every year. Here the fluid for the power steering is also replaced every 2 years because I cannot do 60,000 kilometers on this car. And there, here it is. This funny paint stuff. It was an attempt to do something special, but the paint failed me. It also failed me here in the brake calipers. I don't know why. I used the same paint in another of my car, my 156, and it is very good. Maybe it was humidity at the time, I don't know. The tires are needing to be replaced, I know. This is my... Okay, I have a hammer holding the hood. I cannot find the struts for the hood. Yeah, I can also show you here in the back the brakes. The brakes are original. Sorry, the brake system is original from factory. It's brake disc from factory. Another thing that I had to do when I lowered my car, I only lowered it with coils. With springs, the car became unstable. Not impossible to drive, but a little bit unstable. So I talked to a person, an Alfa Romeo specialist, and he told me, look man, these cars, they do that. When you lower your car, the front of the car, the front axle, pushes out, the wheels push a little bit out, but the rear does not do that because of the way the axle is made. What you have to do is you have to do a certain measure and enlarge the back axle. The wheels must come out a little bit. Okay, that person helped me a lot. It was not the final solution, but helped me understand what I had to do next. That person was the Mr. Rui Palmela. Rui, if you are listening to me, thank you very much for that information. I know it was a long time ago,
but it was a precious information. And from that on, I knew the problem, the next problem, it was almost solved, and it became solved when I adjust the camber of the front wheels. I had the back of the car was unstable, and the problem was at the front. Okay, so all this learning. I adjust the camber of the car in the front, and the problem was solved. I also did the experiment of removing the back spacers, and the car did not like it. So the both things were needed, adjusting the camber at the front and enlarging the rear axle. So thank you very much, Rui. It was a very good information, and I thank you for it. In my video about the cabin air filters, some of you asked me where is the location of the cabin air filter on the 155. It's the same on the 155, 146, 145, and first phase of the Alpha 156 is behind this plate here. You have to put these arms in the upright position, and you have to remove the screws, possibly remove all of this plate off, because if you want to just lift it like this, you will break it. And behind this, there it is, your filter. Okay, you have to change that filter every year. In the back here, we have a large, very large boot. It's very, very helpful. I also have the parking sensors, and I have a rear view camera. Some scratches here. Inside here is a very comfortable car. So much so that my cats love to be in here. I don't let them, but in these days, he has to be. On top here, I have a black, almost like suede fabric. The original starting to sag, and I had to change it. I have here a thermometer with clock, outside and inside thermometer, a fly here, get out of there. My repaired steering wheel, my 2D DVD player, sorry, so you can see better. My original clock, hooray! And I have here some inventions I have to make. In one time, I had problems with my ignition switch, and I have to do waiting for parts. I have to drive my car, so I did this scheme here. I have this main switch with attached to a relay. If you can hear it, okay. This also helps to save battery because it cuts off most of the electrical parts. And I have here a pressure switch and the ignition switch. If I only press the ignition switch without pressing this, the car does not start. Okay, if I press this and this, sorry, the car was in gear. If I press this and this, okay, the car starts. I had no resistance for the plugs, low plugs, so did not start. This third one is just for the DVD, it's a bypass for the DVD. So here it is, everything works. I had some speakers in there, added. It was very difficult to put them there. And okay, hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed these videos. It was a very different from what I used to do. I want to do more of these videos. And if you have any questions about this or any other car, any system of this or other car, I can do it for you. Thank you.